ู่ในแต่ในโรงพยาบาลอยู่แต่ในคลินิกแต่พอเราออกพื้นที่จริงเนี่ยเราก็เจอว่าน้องหมาแต่ละตัวเนี่ยแบบน่าสงสารมากบางตัวอยู่บนกระบะทรายเล็กๆอย่างเงี้ยครับก็ทำให้เรารู้สึกแปลกไปจากที่อยู่ในคลินิกหรือในคณะอย่างเดิมครับอย่างน้อยก็ได้ให้ประสบการณ์ว่าอย่างครั้งนึงเนี่ยเราประเทศไทยน้ำท่วมครั้งเนี้ยเรายังได้มาช่วยน้องหมาน้องแมวที่บางคนอาจจะหลงลืมสัตว์ตัวเล็กๆพวกนี้ไปอย่างเงี้ยครับ
Now I'm in the operation room where people are preparing for the flood release for the animals who are also affected by the flood. And I would like to introduce to you next to me here is Associate Professor Dr. Sutsan Siri Waithiapong, who is also in charge of this operation.
Yes.
Sawasdee
ka. Sawasdee krap.
What is your main duty?
Yes, actually I'm gathering the stuff by people.We have a website and many people knew this website on Facebook and they like to donate many things, especially the feed for the animals, especially for the dog feed and also cat feed. And not only the people from the website, but we also have what we call the friends from many companies like the dog food and cat food companies that donate to us. And also, other things like from our student, they also donate the stuff for the human being, like for the flooding, everyone, like not only dog and cats, but also humans. The effect that you see here is from Faculty of Pharmaceutical Science, Chulalongkorn University, is the pears, poly leaves,of the food or skin problem by the flooding.
This is for human too?
Yes, this is also for human and also for animal.
So what are the people doing right now? Is this their daily routine?
Many students, not only from our faculty, even the secondary school students, they read our website and they come here like volunteer for packing or repack to give to the animal because they said, okay, they have no chance to go with us. Because we still have some problem to go out by ourselves.
So what are the things inside the bag? Can we look at the bag?
Yes. Try to see one or two. Yes.
They all have everything inside, the same thing, right?
Yeah. We have different ones. That one is for the cats.
Oh, okay.
The yellow one. See the string. Yeah.
The green.
Yeah.
This is for dogs.
This is for dog. You have something like the dog food, like this. And so some other small portion.
Right.
Like this.
For the nutrition.
Yeah, for the nutrition. And this is for something like the cleanup bag for the animal. Sometimes you see that, in some house, cats and dogs stay together with humans and it's not really clean, really work for the animal. Some other we call zoonosis from the animal to the human.
Okay, you've been on location to the flood affected areas as well. Can you give us, how was it like?
Yeah.There are many places that we have been, but it's different in places. But some are really in bad situations, like high water and the dog and cats are on the roof, surrounded with water. So what we try to do is to get there as much as possible or as many places as possible to get to the animal.And try to put the feed on the roof or nearby, and also give some additional bag to the people in that area, or who own the pets, or who willing to help the animal without the owners, because they can just pass by every day, they can help to feed the animal over there as well. And most of the time that we see like starving animal, they.Are very very thin with bony condition, so we cannot go everywhere because as you see, traveling to the flooding area is not easy as well.
So traveling there is hard.
Yes.
Getting to everywhere is hard.
It's hard.
It's impossible.
Yes.
Other thing is the animals, they don't know what's happening, so they don't cooperate with you.
Yes, most of the time.Someone asks, why don't you catch those animals and bring back well, it's not that easy. We are wet and we knew that. Actually, the animal should stay in the area if they still be able to survive. But we have to make them survive by give them some food, enough food to stay and leave them in that area. When the flooding disappear, sometimes the owner come back and they can stay with the owner. If you just relocate the animal, sometimes it make other problems in the future.
How long have you been joining this group?
For about 2 or 3 weeks since it was started. Yes.
How do you feel joining and helping?
Actually, I like going with the volunteer group to help people. But like this year with the flood problems, the volunteer camp was, we didn't go, so we came to help in this project instead.
How with this big, you know, in this room there's a lot of stuff in here. How do you guys manage stuff? And you know, there's like diagrams up there. What are they?
Yes. The vet students that are coming to do this, there's one big group from the volunteer camp. They're the main group that manage these things. And they started to design some ways to manage this room and to pack stuff easier.
To save time.
Yes.
So did you ever count how many bags you pack each day?
Actually not, but the first lot of the bags were about 1,000 bags, and they're all gone.
What are one of the things that makes you feel impressed by helping the animals during this hardship time?
Most of the time when we were there with our student, we saw the animal with bony conditions, and they scare of us. When we reach them, they just try to swim away from us. But when they knew that we try to help them by giving them some food in the dry area, they just swim back and catch the food and eat. And we look at them with, well, maybe tearful. Most of the time, it's very nice to see that, okay, we can help. Even though it's not all the animal that we can do, but okay, when we saw this one and we can help this one, it's very good for us. Some has other health problems like the car accident. We will try to treat first aid of the animals here.